सुजनार्बुदराधित पाद युगम युगधर मधुरांधर पात्रवर वरदावयदायक पोज पदम प्रणमामि अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरुवे नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय राधिकाय प्रियात्मने श्रीश्रीमद्भक्तिवेदान्तनारायणाति नाम्ने मध्येयं श्रीगुरुवरं रूपानुगप्रवरं व्रजरसरसीगंसनारायणतं प्रपन्नम् नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतल श्रीमते भक्तिसिद्धान्त सरस्वती नाम्ने ನಮ ಮಹೋದನ್ಯಾಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಪ್ರದಾತ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಚೈತನ್ಯಂ ಗೌರತಿ ಜೇ ನಮ ಹೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕರುಣಾ ಸಿಂಧು ದೇನ ಬಂಧ ಜಗತ್ಪತ ಗೋಪೇಶ ಗೋಪಿಕ ಕಾಂತ ರಾಧ ಕಾಂತ ನಮ ತಪ್ತ ಕಾಂಚನ ಗೌರಂಗಿ ರಾಧೆ ವೃಂದಾವನೇಶ್ವರಿ ವಸುವಾನುಸತೇ ದೇವಿ ಪ್ರಣಮಾಮಿ ಹರಿ ಪ್ರಿಯ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಪ್ರಭು ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಶ್ರೀ ಅದ್ವೈತ ಗದಾಧರ ಶಿವಾಸದಿ ಗೌರ ಭಕ್ತರಂದ ಬಲ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ 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 ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ ಸತ್ಯ ಮೇಲೆ ಮಧ್ಯ ಗುರುಪಾದ ಪದ್ಮ ನಿತ್ಯಲೇಲು ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪಾದ ಪರಮಂಸ ಗುರುವಾಚಕ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಅಷ್ಟೋತ್ತರ ಸದಸ್ಯ ಸಂಭಕ್ತಿ ವೇದಾಂತ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಅಭಯ ಚರಣ ಗಮನ ಅನಂತಕೋಟಿ ದಂಡವರ್ಪಣ ಜಾಪನ ಕರ್ತವ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಆಯ್ತಿ ಕೃಪಾ ಪ್ರಾತಕತ್ವ ರೂಪ ಆನು ಗುರುವರ್ಗ ಚರಣ ಗಮನ ಅನಂತಕೋಟಿ ದಂಡವತ್ ಪ್ರಣಾಮಕ್ಕೆ ಆಯ್ತಿ ಕೃಪಾ ಪ್ರಾತಕತ್ವ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಸಿದ್ಧಾರ್ಥ ಸರ್ಸೆ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಗೋಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಗುರುಪಾದ ಚರಣ ಗಮನ ಅನಂತಕೋಟಿ ದಂಡವತ್ ಪ್ರಣಾಮಕ್ಕೆ ಆಯ್ತಿ ಕೃಪಾ ಪ್ರಾತಕತ್ವ ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತ ವೈಷ್ಣವ ಸಜ್ಜನ ಮಂಡಳಿ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವೇದ ಸಿದ್ಧಾರ್ಮ ಚರಣ ಗಮನ ಅನಂತಕೋಟಿ ದಂಡವತ್ ಪ್ರಣಾಮಕ್ಕೆ ಆಯ್ತಿ ಕೃಪಾ ಪ್ರಾತಕ ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತ ವೈಷ್ಣವ ಸೊ ಆಜ ಸ್ಥಾನ ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತ ಹುಯೇ ಹಾಂ ಯೇ ಹೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಗೌಡಿಯ ಮಠ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಬಹುಪಾದ ಜಿ ಕಾ ಔರ್ ಭಾವ ಸ್ಥಳ ಹೈ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವಿಕಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಗೌಡಿಯ ಮಠ ಬರ್ತ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಪ್ರಭುಪಾದ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫೌಂಡರ್ ಆಫ್ 64 ಗೌಡಿಯ ಮಠ ಸೊ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಈಶಾ ದತ್ತು ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ವಿಶ್ವನಾಥ್ ಚಕ್ರವರ್ತಿ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಲದೇವಿ ದೇವಭೂಷಣ್ ಪ್ರಭು ದರ್ 200 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಏಜ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಗೌಡಿಯ ವೈಷ್ಣವಾಸ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಸಹಜಿಯಾಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಯೂಜಿಂಗ್ ಮಹಾಪ್ರಭುಸ್ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ದ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಹಾಪ್ರಭು ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ದಮ್ ಸರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಫಾಲೋವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಹಾಪ್ರಭು ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಈ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್ ಟು ಜಗನ್ನಾಥ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್ ಟು ವಿಮಲಾದೇವಿ ದಟ್ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ಎ ರೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ ಹೂ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬ್ರೀತ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಹೂ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೆಲಿವರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಸೊ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟರ್ನಲ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಹಾಪ್ರಭು ಅಂಡ್ ರಾಧಾಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸೊ ಬೈ ಹಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್ಸ್ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ರಾಜರಾಣಿ ಮರ್ಸಿಫುಲಿ ಶಿ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಹರ್ ಮೈಡ್ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ ನಯನಮಣಿ ಮಂಜರಿ ಹಿ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಹಿ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಸರಸ್ವತ ಪ್ರಭುಪಾದ್ ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ಬಾರನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ಸಾ ದ ಬೇಬಿ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಹಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಭಾಗವತಿ ದೇವಿ ಇಸ್ ವೈಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಆಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಎ ಕಂಠಿ ಮಾಲ ಅಂಡ್ ತಿಲಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಿನ್ ಥ್ರೆಡ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಆನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಕೇರ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಂತ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ರಥಯಾತ್ರೆ ವಾಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಜಗನ್ನಾಥ್ ರಥ್ ಕೇಮ್ ನಿಯರ್ ದ ದಿಸ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಜಗನ್ನಾಥ್ ರಥ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ 3 days ಸೊ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಟು ಫುಲ್ ರಥ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ವೇ ಯು ನೋ bringing elephant and other things, many things they are trying to use to pull the rath, but the rath was not moving. Then that time Bhakti Vinod Thakur was the manager of this festival. He is a district magistrate, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. So he took the baby, the Vimala Prasa, and he went to the top of the that, near Jagannath Rath, and there he offered Jagannath, the baby, the Vimala Prasa. Immediately Jagannath garland fell down on his neck. So Bhakti Vinod Thakur is confirmed this is the blessings of Jagannath. And that is the same time Bhakti Vinod Thakur took some Mahaprasada from Jagannath and he made that Annaprasna, first grain giving ceremony for the child. So in this way, Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada he performed his Bal Leela, childhood pattern. Then Bhakti Vinod Thakur used to give pravachan and amateur preaching. And Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, when he is a small child, when he is 5 years old, he learned all Bhagavad Gita slokas. and many other slokas he learned from Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur, whenever he is going to give pravachan, Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada used to follow him. He used to carry Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Chaitanya Charita Amrita, Ujjala Neelamani, all these granthas, books he used to carry in his head. And he used to sit down and with everybody he used to listen very carefully the Harikatha. And after Bhaktivinoda Thakur gave him the Harinam and he gave Kurma Mantra. So how to worship Lord Kurmadev? So Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, when he is going to school, he learned all the education. Then he has become a big scholar. So when he was going to the school and college, he heard that in the college lecturer going to explain the Chaitanya Charitamrita and other philosophy, but they are explaining in the Mayavadi philosophy. That way they were explaining. But Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada used to cut all their arguments. He said, "What I can learn from you? So I don't want to study in this school and colleges." And he also, by the blessings of Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, he also learned astrology, Jyotishya. He learned that one. And Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj instructed him that you should make a Vaishnava calendar, Vaishnava Panjika. All the acharyas' appearance and disappearance, and Mahaprabhu, Nityananda, Baladev Prabhu, Ramchandra Bhagavan, Narasingha Bhagavan, Krishna's appearance, all this. So, once the king of Tripura, he has called Bhaktivinoda Thakur, "So I need a teacher for my child. My son wants to learn something, so I need a teacher." Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, "My son is a very learned scholar, he will teach your son." And that king has got a big library. In that library, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he was reading all Shastra, Puranas, Upanishads, everything. He was like Sritidhar. Once he read anything and he remembered everything. So he was teaching his son how to chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. What is the purpose of life? Why you came in this material world? Who am I? Where I am coming from? After this living body, where I will go? What is our goal of life? All these things he was teaching to the king's son. The king's son was very much impressed by the Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada instruction. He also started wearing Kanti Mala and Tilak, and he started Harinam, chanting Harinam. And he was not so much interested in family life now. That queen was very worried about the son. And he immediately called the king and he told, "I don't want this teacher. Please send him whatever money he wants. How much money he wants, we will give. But we don't want that he should instruct my son. My son will become sannyasi. I don't want to, because we need to continue this, the Vamsa Parampara." So then the king has called Bhaktivinoda Thakur, "I will give a salary that you please call your son." Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada said, "We don't want your salary, and what purpose I came here, that purpose is fulfilled. So I am going." So he came back. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he learned all the scriptures, everything. Once Bhaktivinoda Thakur was giving Harikatha here in Puri. That time many people used to come and hear Harikatha from Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is very merciful. Poor in any sampradaya they come, and he was very, when he gives instruction, very soft. Everybody is to slowly he will convince and bring them to the lotus feet of Jagannath and Radha Krishna Mahaprabhu. So once Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he told Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada that, "I am going for somewhere, you please give the pravachan." Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur started giving pravachan. he was very heavy. So he is really trying to follow the, give the instruction of six Goswami and our Guru Varga. So he was cutting all the argument of all the Apasiddhanta, Sahajiyas, all these things he was cutting. And many people, after hearing the powerful Harikatha of Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, and they left, they are not coming back again. Slowly, slowly, there were 200 people used to hear Harikatha. Then slowly it became 100, then 50, then 25. By the time Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he came, he saw only few people are hearing Harikatha. So, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and he told that, you know, you no need to give Harikatha, I will continue to give Harikatha. So, because if you give Harikatha, everybody will go away. So, once the Bhaktivinoda Thakur's Gurudev, Bipin Bihari Goswami, he came to Bhaktivinoda Thakur's house, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur offered his obeisance to his Gurudev. Bipin Bihari Goswami, he kept his lotus feet on the head of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So after Bhaktivinoda Thakur left, he went inside. Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he told the Bhaktivinoda Thakur Gurudev, you know who is my father? He is not ordinary person. He is eternal associate of Mahaprabhu and Radha Krishna. So you have no power to give, you have no capacity to give your lotus feet on the head of my Guru, my father and my Guru. So when Bhaktivinoda Thakur afterwards, when he came, that Bipin Bihari Goswami, he told, your son is very powerful. He knows all the things. So then Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he told Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he has purchased some land in Mayapur. He told that he should develop and maintain this one. Somehow he should maintain. Because he is trying to give him some kind of work, you know, some medical, you know, opening the homeopathic medicine shop and many other things he tried to give to the Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada. But he is not able to maintain that one. Even astrological calculation, all these things, Jyotishya, he said, I am not came for the count of the stars. And I am not meant for any of this material work. So he was, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told him that he should maintain this yoga pita. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he discovered that Mahaprabhu's birthplace, Yogapit, and he called Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. He prayed to him, please confirm this place. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj has confirmed that place. This is the place of Mahaprabhu. There are many people are present, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, many scriptural proof, he written Navadev Dham Mahatma, and he also told that Bhakti Saraswati that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's birthplace in the eastern side, in Mayapur. So, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was doing bhajan in Godrum Dev, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj used to come. He used to always singing, Kathayego Prema Mahi Radhe Radhe. This kind of Vipralamba bhajan he was singing. Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, when he heard that he was in such a deep, you know, suppression mode, he was very much interested, and he asked Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur told that you should take Diksha from him. Bhaktivinoda Thakur already gave him the Harinam and Kurma Mantra. Now he told you should accept Diksha from the Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. But Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj always is telling, I will ask Nithai Gauranga, if they give permission, I will accept this effort. Otherwise, I will not accept. Because I made a vow, I will not accept any disciple. So, many times, Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, whenever he is asking, oh, I forgot to ask, tomorrow I will ask him. Then Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he started fasting. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he told Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, that you want to kill my son, what is real Jivadaya? So you should please accept my son. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is a Shiksha Guru of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. Then Gaur Kishore Das was recent disciple and first disciple, that is Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was doing bhajan in Vrindavan, in Suryakund, in many other places he was doing bhajan. And also he was doing bhajan in Navadev Dham. So much separation mood. Like Raghunath Das Goswami, he used to do bhajan. And he has got so much wealth of prem, pancham purusharth. So all this, the wealth, that prem purusharth, he gave to Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada. Even though many other people are so-called six disciples, they were asking that we are also follower of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. But Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj really did not accept any other disciple, only one disciple. So Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he has got so much spiritual wealth. From Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj and Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. Then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada in Yogapeeth in Mayapur. And he started chanting Satakoti Naam Jap. It took for him almost 9 years. One day, if you try to chant 3 lakh, in 1 month you can finish 1 crore. So like that, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he followed the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, and he was chanting Satakoti Naam Jap. And when he was about to finish this one, that time Panchatattva, all Guru Parampara appeared to him, gave him the blessing that now your bhajan is completed, now you should distribute. You have got so much prem, that spiritual wealth. Now the time for you to distribute this prem. He said, I don't have any manpower and money power. How can I do this one? I am alone. He said, you should start. We will send whatever you want. Everything we will send. By the mercy of Mahaprabhu and his associate and Guru Varga Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he got everything. Many learned scholars and young people, they become his disciples, and Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he established the Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math. He started that building, the Gaudiya Math temple. This is the Seva Kunj. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada first he told, I will build in the Navadvip Dham, every dvipa I will build a mat, and also all over the India and also all over the world. So when he was in this material world, he built 64 Gaudiya Math. And after his disciple Bhaktivinoda Swami Prabhupada, he went to the western countries and he preached there, and he has built like 100 centers. And all his, then Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada disciples, they also built his done. And so he was preaching by his mercy. His disciples and grand disciples, they were preaching all over the world. Now still this parampara is continuing. So we offer our respect to Lobisant Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, how he did bhajan. So we also want to try to follow the Rupanuga Guru Varga. And after my humble obeisances, Manchakal Padra Vesa Kripa Siddhu Vesa Patita Anupanu Vashnu Yo Namo.
Gurgul Gaur Chandraya Radhikaya Tadalaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadvaktaya Namo 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 Vishnu Padaya Shri Radhikaya Priyatmane Shri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami Ki Namine. First of all, I pay my humble obeisances at the lotus feet of my Diksha Gurudev, Nitya Leela Pravishto, Vishnu Pada Stotra Shastra Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. After that, I pay my humble obeisances at the lotus feet of my Shiksha Gurudev, Om Vishnu Pada Stotra Shastra Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, and I pay my obeisances to the Vaishnava and Vaishnavis present over here. As we have heard from Prabhuji, he described the birth pastime of Srila Prabhupada that how he was, how he came in this world by the call of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Like Bhakti Vinod Thakur seeing the condition of the society, he called, he went in Jagannath temple and he prayed to Vimla Devi that, oh Vimla Devi, you are the potency of the Lord. And so he went to the potency of the Lord and asked that you send a leader who can preach in this world about Shuddha pure bhakti. And after that, Srila Prabhupada was named as Vimla Prasad. So we have heard that, we have heard many of the pastimes. As we have very less time and also we have walked a lot and we are feeling hungry, Srila Prabhupada, if we can conclude, he is like Gunandav. He is similar to Bhagavan, like Gunandav. He is filled with so many qualities, so many qualities. If we will start talking about all the qualities, the time will be very less, the qualities are so much. So what we can do is, from his pastimes, we can just focus on few pastimes and try to learn few things from his pastimes. Like, we are sitting over here, we are doing parikrama, we are chanting. Who is the person whom we are dipped to? It's Srila Prabhupada. If he wouldn't have come on earth, we wouldn't have been sitting here and chanting Hare Krishna. It's just by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada. He is what? He is the personified deity of mercy of Sri Krishna. He came and he distributed this Krishna Prem to everyone. I just remember one pastime which shows how merciful he was. Once he sent few of his disciples to preach in some area where there was no preaching ever done. So it was just a raw area. So the disciples, they went over there and they started preaching. They preached for months, and some after few months they gathered few devotees over there, and then they arranged for a land, they built a temple, they started building a temple. And then the day came when the deities were to be installed, and then they called Srila Prabhupada that, oh, the day has come and the deities has to be installed. So Prabhupada said, okay, the day was fixed and Prabhupada ticket was fixed and he was to go there. Meanwhile, what happened was, there was one brahmachari in that group. He did some misconduct. So the sannyasi, the senior sannyasi, the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, they chastised brahmachari and told him to just go away because you are not good. You have done such misconduct. Okay, this thing happened, and now the day came. Srila Prabhupada, he arrived on the station and everyone just went to receive Srila Prabhupada. He was offered garlands, there were kirtan going on. And Srila Prabhupada, he was observing each and everyone. He was seeing, oh, he has come, he has come. And then he inquired, oh, where is that new brahmachari? That little brahmachari, where is he? Where is that new boy? So the sannyasis told the entire story. Oh, this thing happened and he did some misconduct, misbehavior. So we chastised him and we just told him to get away. So Prabhupada said that, I'm not stepping into that mud, that new temple. I will not install the deities until and unless you find that new boy. So all the sannyasis, the disciples of Prabhupada and other brahmacharis, they were running here and there to search that new boy. Where is he? Where would he be? So one of the brahmacharis, he came and he said, I just guess because that new boy, one day he repaired somebody's watch. There was some problem in the watch, so he repaired that watch. So maybe now he has left the mart, so he doesn't have anything to eat, or so for money, he might be working in some watch shop. So that, okay, now search all the shops. So they will search every watch shop, and in one of the watch shops, they found that boy. He was repairing a watch. So the brahmachari told the entire story to him and said,
You know what has happened? And that boy, when he saw the brahmachari, he started just crying out of guilt that what misbehavior he did in past. So he started crying. And he said that that's because of I got scared. I felt that I won't be able to face the sannyasis again and Srila Prabhupada. So I just ran away. I don't want to go back. But they told that, you know what? Srila Prabhupada is calling you. Just come. And then that boy was taken to Srila Prabhupada. And then Prabhupada just embraced him. And he said to the sannyasis and everyone, you know how much energy, how much blood has been given to just to make one person a Krishna devotee. We all are but jivas. We will do something, some bad, sometimes some bad thing, something, anything. But the thing should not be, we should not chastise or criticize anyone. We should always focus that how we can make him a devotee. So by this past time, we can see he was very strict. Prabhupada was very strict, very strict. But by this past time, it showed that how compassionate he is for each and every jiva. He has come here for us. He came here for us. The Guru Parampara has come for us. They are so compassionate. And even the Vaishnava who was telling this past time, he said that Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada is still present. And if I am doing some misbehavior or any misconduct, I know I should be feeling guilty, but side by side, I should pray to Srila Prabhupada. I should pray to my Gurudev that, oh, I'm so unfortunate. I'm not able to follow your instructions. Just bless me. And you know, there was one another pastime that Srila Prabhupada with his associates, sannyasis and brahmacharis, he was going on preaching tour. So they were walking from one village to another. So what happened was that Prabhupada, he was walking in front with few sannyasis, and they crossed one small hut. And the moment Prabhupada crossed that hut, an old lady, she came out of the hut with one lemon and few chilies. And she came out and she gave that thing to a brahmachari. Oh, please, please take this. And that brahmachari, he just laughed. Ha ha, you don't have anything. We just keep it with you. We have, no problem. And after walking few miles, Prabhupada got to know that this thing happened. So Prabhupada, he asked that brahmachari, where is that house? Where is that hut? He said, oh Prabhupada, it's few miles back. We cannot go back. Prabhupada said, no, we have to. Prabhupada, with all his associates, went back to that hut, knocked the door, called that old lady. Oh, what were you giving, Mata? Just give it to me. And everyone was surprised that what is happening? Just for a lemon and few chilies, he has walked these miles back. Why is he doing this? We don't need that one lemon and few chilies. We have plenty of foodstuff with us. Then Prabhupada told, it is after millions and millions and millions of birth, a jiva somehow, that servitude, the tendency to serve, it just appears in the heart of a jiva. And today, this appeared in this heart of this old woman. And you just stopped it. This, if you would have taken it, the things, we would have offered it to Thakurji. So just think, slowly and slowly, this tendency of serving Hari, Guru and Vaishnavas develop in the heart of a jiva. And we are here to do this only. We are here on a preaching tour. What we are preaching? We are preaching this thing only, that we have to, the jiva is there to serve Hari, Guru and Vaishnavas only. So if today I wouldn't have taken this lemon and chili from this old lady,
the thing, this tendency of serving would have stopped. And I don't know for how many billions of births again she would have just suffered. So now, today, if that service attitude has come in her and we have offered that thing which she has just given to Thakurji, then this will gradually increase. And one day she will surely come in pure Krishna Bhakti and she'll go back to Godhead. So why? And just see, the place where we are sitting, mud. Who made this mud? Why this mud was made? Why this idea of mud came? This idea of mud was introduced by Srila Prabhupada only. Why? Madhanti Vasanti Shatrani. It is not that the mud is just a school. It's not just a school. It's more than that. Over here, it's like a school, but it's more than a school. That the people who have anukul vatavaran, unfavorable conditions at their home place, they are not able to do bhajan at their home, they can come here and stay and do bhajan. And grihasthas who are staying nearby, they can also come and do bhajan over there. So it's a common platform, a common place for everyone to come and learn how to do bhajan and then do bhajan. So what is this mud? This is a place where everyone should come with an attitude that, oh, I'm going there to learn something about Krishna Bhakti, Krishna Prem. Because see, everyone over here, some are flying from Russia, Australia, so far away places. For what are we coming over here? Delicious prasad, like last night one Maharaj was saying, no. What are we coming here for? Oh, we will go to Puri and we will do shopping? Indian shopping or Indian dishes? No. He made these places so that we can come, we can unite and we can discuss something about Krishna. We can learn something about this devotion. We can learn something about sadhana. But a jiva like me, he's wasting this opportunity. What is he doing? He's coming here and he's talking nonsense. Oh, you know that Prabhuji, what is happening with him? You know that Mataji, what she is doing? You know what is this? So what is happening? A jiva like me, he is missing this opportunity which Srila Prabhupada gave. And see, Prabhupada made mud. And when Srila Param Gurudev, he came out of the mool mud, Sri Chaitanya mud, he again made a mud. Like Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj also, he also established mud. And in the parampara, they kept on establishing mud. Why? Just to keep that idea living. That the muds are a place where we take out some time. We come here to learn about sadhan bhajan. But a jiva like me, he's wasting it also. Like, we have come here for parikrama. We're staying in mud. We know we will go back and then we will be again involved in our day-to-day life. Few will be busy in their job, few in their studies, few in their family life, few in their business. But this opportunity which we have got, and parikrama, who started this parikrama? Srila Prabhupada started this parikrama. A Guru Varga, they preserved that idea. For what? For giving us an opportunity to learn, to develop some things, to develop some sanskars in us so that we can do Krishna Bhakti. We know, Ajiva like me, he cannot do just Krishna Bhakti as it is. But to make sanskars. What is sanskar? Sanskar is impressions. Like I'm chanting, I'm doing parikrama under the guidance of Vaishnavas. They are developing some sanskars. They're making some impressions in me. I'm learning few things over here. So when I go back, like people from Russia, they go back to Russia, their home, China, back to China. What they will do? They will think, oh, we went in parikrama. We were staying with Vaishnavas. I learned this over there. Oh, I heard this thing about Srila Prabhupada. Oh, I heard this thing about Param Gurudev. Oh, I heard this thing about Srila Gurudev. So what? Those learnings, you have to implement it. The parikrama is not ending. It is not that parikrama has ended. The actual parikrama will start when you go back to your home. From day one. Because this time, the time which you spent here in Navdeep and Puri, what you have done? You have collected a lot of charge. You have collected a lot of learnings, a lot of teachings. And now, when you will go back to your place, go back to your home, you will start implementing it. So that time the actual parikrama starts. That I have to implement it. I have gathered a lot of theory. But now it is the practical application. Oh, I learned that Gurudev, even Srila Param Gurudev and Srila Prabhupada said, never to criticize anyone. Now it is the real situation. I have to follow it. Because now we are so busy in parikrama that we don't think about these things. But when we are back home, then these things will gather. We will be in tough situations. Right now we are chanting so many rounds. But when we go back, like Maharaj was saying, it is really very hard to chant even 16 rounds. At the night, at 12 o'clock, oh my God, I just forgot 2 rounds to complete my 16. So the tough situations are coming ahead. So Srila Prabhupada, he just established everything. His personified deity of what? Mercy of Krishna. So we should pray at his lotus feet. I am praying at his lotus feet. That whatever, you have given so many teachings. You have given so many things from the scriptures. I know I am unqualified. I am unqualified even to understand it. So just have mercy on me. So that I can understand few things. I should have faith in my Guru. I have faith in Vaishnavas. Then the faith will come there in Thakurji. So, I just pray at the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada that for the thing which you came over here, just have mercy on me that I understand a little of it. I understand a little of the reason for which my Gurudev came, and somehow make me an equipment for the mission for which you have come. Like, I consider myself as a piece of coal and this mission to a very big fire. So what a coal can do? It can just jump in that fire and maybe support that fire for maybe a million seconds. So just we should have that feeling in our heart that I somehow become an equipment in the hands of Hari Guru and Vaishnavas so that they can utilize me for this service. Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari.
ठाकुर की बोले श्री भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर की बोले श्री विमाल विमला प्रसाद की भक्ति दैत माधव गोस्वामी महाराज की भक्ति वल्लभ तीर्थ महाराज की निताय गौर ब्रह्मानंदे हरि हरि बोल हरे कृष्णा। हाँ बोले गुरुदेव की। हाँ अभी हम लोग ने जहाँ पर आए हैं ये स्थान का ना ये क्या है बोले श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद का ये जन्म स्थान है। इसलिए हमारे पद्म पुराण में एक श्लोक आया है, वो पद्म पुराण में श्लोक में कहते हैं, चत्वरास्ते कलौ भाभ्यात् उत्कले पुरुषतमात्। ये श्लोक है, हैं? इसका मतलब है ये पहले से ही बता दिया कलयुग आने पर कि ये जितने सारे वैष्णव संप्रदाय कहाँ से प्रकट होएंगे। बोले उत्कल पुरुषतमात्, उत्कल मतलब ये उड़ीसा पुरुषतम क्षेत्र से ही ये सारे परिक्रमा व सारे प्रचार यहीं से शुरू होगा। इसलिए पहले से ही ये बात को बता चुके हैं। हरे कृष्णा। इसलिए ये पद्म पुराण का भविष्यवाणी के हिसाब से ही ये प्रभुपाद यहीं पर जन्म हुए हैं, यहीं पर उन्होंने हम लोगों ने श्रवण किया है कैसे उन्होंने जन्म ग्रहण की, श्री प्रभुपाद कैसे जन्म ग्रहण करते हैं यहीं पर ही हैं। जब ये भित्ति खनन कर रहे थे यहीं से ही कुर्मदेव यहीं से ही प्रकट हुए, और श्री भक्त विनोद ठाकुर ने श्रील प्रभुपाद को कुर्मदेव का मंत्र दिए और उनका तिलक लगाना, आचमन करना, कैसे पूजा करना, तब भक्तमय ठाकुर उनको पूजा की विधि विधान दे करके उनको पूजा में लगाए। यहाँ प्रश्न होता है, भैया प्रभुपाद कौन है? बोले राधा रानी की नयन मणि मंजर, राधा रानी के अनुचर है। अरे हो करके ये कुर्मदेव का पूजा कैसे की? गोपियाँ जिस समय रास में कृष्ण अंतर ध्यान हुए, कृष्ण ने चतुर्भुज रूप धारण करके बैठ गए, जब गोपियों ने आए ना, लेकिन गोपियाँ तो देखा विष्णु को, नारायण को, लेकिन उन्होंने प्रणाम किया लेकिन आसक्ति नहीं हुई। उन्होंने पूछे हमारे श्याम सुंदर कहीं देखे हो, हमारे कृष्ण के कहीं देखे हो? उन्हें नारायण को दर्शन करते हुए भी उनके प्रति आकृष्ट नहीं हुए, लेकिन फिर प्रभुपाद ये कुर्मदेव हैं, ये कुर्मदेव को उन्होंने कैसे उपासना की है? कदि ये साधारण कुर्मदेव नहीं है, कहते महाप्रभु को शरीर में जब अष्ट साथी के भाव प्रकट होता था, उनका शरीर भी कुर्मदेव जैसे हो जाता था, सारे शरीर अंदर में चला जाता था, हैं? हाथ पैर सब के सब अंदर में गुजर जाता था। इसलिए ये जो कुर्मदेव है ये कोई साधारण कुर्मदेव नहीं, ये अष्ट साथी के प्रेम से विकार से ये कुर्मदेव है, ये साधारण कुर्मदेव नहीं। इसलिए यहीं पर उनकी रुचि परीक्षा हुई, जब बच्चा घुटन पर चलता है रुचि परीक्षा होता है, इसलिए भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर ने उनको सामने बहुत सारी चीज रख ली, उनको सामने ये श्रीमद् भागवत ग्रंथ भी रखे, लेकिन प्रभुपाद घुटन पर चलते 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 उन्होंने किसको आलिंगन किया? बोले श्री भागवत ग्रंथ का आलिंगन किया। इसलिए इसको देख करके प्रभु श्री भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर बड़े प्रसन्न हो गए, समझ गए भविष्य में ये बच्चा ने ये पृथ्वी में ये जो भागवत धर्म को जगत में ये प्रचार करेगा। सचमुच से प्रभुपाद ने संपूर्ण जगत में ये भागवत धर्म को उन्होंने पूर्ण रूप में उन्होंने प्रचार किया है। यहीं पर श्री भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर का और भी बहुत सारी संतान थे। एक दिन भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर एक संतान बड़ी बीमारी में पड़ी और प्रभुपाद उनको सेवा कर रहे थे, हैं? उनको सेवा कर रहे थे और सेवा करते करते हठात उनको जो एक संतान था उनको ललाट में रामानुज संप्रदाय का चिन्ह, हाँ, तिलक का चिन्ह हठात प्रकट हुआ। प्रकट होकर के वो प्रभुपाद को कह रहे हैं, बोले देखो मैं पहले जन्म में रामानुज संप्रदाय में एक बहुत बड़ा आचार्य था, लेकिन मैंने ये गौड़ीय वैष्णव को उन्होंने मैंने क्रिटिसाइज किया है, वैष्णव को मैंने क्रिटिसाइज किया है, निंदा किया है इनकी। इसलिए वो बहुत बड़े आचार्य थे लेकिन वैष्णव निंदा इतने खतरनाक, इसलिए मेरे को ये वैष्णव अपराध से मुक्त होने के लिए ये भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर का आश्रय लेना पड़ा। ये बहुत बड़े साधु थे, हैं? बहुत आश्रय मेरे को लेकर इनके बच्चे रूप में जन्म ग्रहण करना पड़ा। और वो कह रहे हैं भविष्य में जो तुम हो ये वैष्णव संप्रदाय के बहुत बड़े साधु तू बनने वाले हो, इसलिए मेरे अपराध को माफ कर दो, मेरे अपराध को माफ कर दो, फिर मेरे उद्धार होगा, नहीं तो उद्धार होने वाले नहीं। इसलिए वैष्णव अपराध इतना खतरा है, इसलिए भक्त श्री रूप गोस्वामी कहते हैं, मेरे भैया भक्ति ज्यादा नहीं हो कोई बात नहीं, ज्यादा नहीं हो कोई बात नहीं, लेकिन कभी वैष्णव का निंदा पिंदा मत किया करो, वैष्णव की निंदा पिंदा मत किया करो। निंदा करोगे तो महाप्रभु कहते जैसे कि मतवाला हाथी किसी बाघ में चले जाए और सूर में पूरा जड़ समेत उसको उन्होंने उखाड़ दे, उसी तरह भक्ति लता बीज को, भक्ति लता को पूरा की पूरा उखाड़ देती है, मतलब भक्ति करने का और भावना नहीं रह जाएगी, हृदय सूख जाएगी, हरिनाम करने की इच्छा नहीं करेगी, हैं भजन करने की इच्छा नहीं करेगी। इसलिए 10 तरह का जो हमारे नामापराध में, उसमें गुरुदेव का सर्वश्रेष्ठ बताया है, गुरुदेव का चरण में अपराध सबसे खतरा है, लेकिन वहां पर गुरुदेव का उसने तीसरे नंबर में बताया, लेकिन पहला नंबर में क्या बताया, वैष्णव अपराध। बोले क्यों? बोले गुरु जी को तो गुरु जी मानते हैं, हमारे गुरु जी है हमारे, लेकिन कभी कभी वैष्णव लोगों को ना इतना आदर नहीं करते, वैष्णव को आदर नहीं करते, इसलिए हमारे महाराज कहते हैं, बोले नहीं, गुरु वैष्णव भगवान तीनों को आदर करनी चाहिए, तीनों को सबको यथा योग्य हमें सम्मान देनी चाहिए। इसलिए भक्त विनोद ठाकुर कहते हैं, प्रभु कब ऐसे दिन आएगा, बोले कहते ना गुरुदेव बड़ा कृपा करी गौरव नवाजे, गोद्र में दिया च स्थान, आज्ञा दिलम रे यही ब्रज वसी हरि नाम कर गा। ये भजन में कहते गुरुदेव हमें ये कृपा करो, सबको जैसे जथा योग्य हम सम्मान दे करके भगवान की भक्ति में हम बढ़ सके। इसलिए श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु अपना माँ को भी उन्होंने माफ नहीं किया, अपना मैया को भी उन्होंने माफ नहीं किया, उन्होंने मैया को है, इसलिए बोले मैया ने वैष्णव अपराध किए, इसलिए कहाँ भगवान की माँ है, उनको अद्वैत आचार्य चरण में माफी मांगना पड़ा। इसलिए कहते साधु सावधान, साधु सावधान है, इसलिए फेर करी कही अवधान, महाप्रसादे गोविंदे नाम ब्रह्मणे वैष्णवे, सल्प पुन्नंग पतंग राजन विश्वास नैव जाते। यहाँ वैष्णव नाम आया, वैष्णव को सल्प पुण्य बतांग राजन, जिसका पुण्य कम है उनके प्रति उनका विश्वास नहीं होता है, ठीक है ना। इसलिए यहीं पर ये लीला, यहीं पर उन्होंने यही लीला हुई थी, इसलिए ये प्रभुपाद ने हैं, प्रभुपाद ने यहीं से जन्म ग्रहण करते हुए हैं, भक्तिमत ठाकुर का गोद का आश्रय ग्रहण करते हुए जब रथ यात्रा हो रही थी, यहीं पर ही रथ ही रास्ता में, यहीं पर रास्ता में रथ अटक गया था, 3 दिन तक अटक गया था है? जब श्री भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर प्रभुपाद को लेकर उनको चरण में प्रणाम कराया, उसको बाद में फिर रथ यहाँ से धीरे 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 रथ यहाँ से चलना शुरू हो गया। इसलिए हम उधर वहाँ प्रभुपाद की कथा सुन रहे थे, अभी जो थोड़ी बहुत हम भगवान की भक्ति करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, यही महापुरुष का कृपा, अगर ये नहीं आते है ना, इसलिए प्रभुपाद का शिष्य लोग कहते हैं, अगर ये प्रभुपाद जगत में नहीं आते हैं ना, ये दुनिया अभी नहीं रहता, ये दुनिया ध्वंस हो जाता, ये दुनिया ध्वंस हो जाता। बोले क्यों? बोले भगवान दुनिया को क्यों बनाए? बोले भजन करने के लिए थोड़ी, खाने पीने के लिए ये दुनिया थोड़ी बनाए, ये खाने पीने के लिए इस दुनिया भगवान नहीं बनाए, भगवान तो इसलिए बनाए भगवान की भक्ति करे। इसलिए अगर भक्ति प्रभुपाद आए तभी ये दुनिया में हरि कीर्तन हो रहे हैं, केवल दुनिया नहीं संपूर्ण विश्व में, संपूर्ण विश्व में जो हरि नाम कीर्तन इनकी कृपा से हो रही है। अगर आपको पता होगा सब सब देश में सब एटम बम बना करके रखे, अभी पाकिस्तान में होने जा रहा था ना, पाकिस्तान भारत में होने जा रहा था, उसमें टीवी में दिखा रहा था ना, अगर ये विश्व युद्ध छिड़ जाएगा तो क्या होगा, कितने कितने आधा बम पूरा नहीं जो एटम बम और आधा यूज करेंगे, ये पूरा विश्व संपूर्ण ये नष्ट हो जाएगा, ये विश्व नष्ट हो जाएगा हैं, इसलिए एटम बम बन, लेकिन अभी गिरा क्यों नहीं रहे, बना कर क्यों रखे, वो गिरेगा ही, लेकिन बना करके रखे क्यों, वो गिरेगा, लेकिन इसलिए युद्ध होते होते बंद हो गया। भगवान को पता है अभी कुछ हरे कृष्ण है, अभी कुछ हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम, राम राम हरे हरे, अभी भी कुछ लोग हरे कृष्ण नाम जप कर रहे हैं। अभी मेरे कुछ भक्त लोग हैं, अगर ये एटम बम गिरेगा तो ये भी मर जाएंगे। लेकिन कृष्ण गीता में कहते हैं, अर्जुन कौनते प्रतिज्ञानी नामे भक्त प्रणशति, तुम प्रतिज्ञा करो मेरे भक्तों का विनाश नहीं। इसलिए वो एटम युद्ध होते तो बंद हो गया। इसलिए कृष्ण देखा है मेरे भक्त मर जाएंगे, इसलिए कहता अगर प्रभुपाद नहीं आता है ना, ये दुनिया कब खत्म हो जाता, कब ये दुनिया खत्म हो जाता। इसलिए प्रभुपाद बोलते थे, बोले चिंता मत करो, बोले हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम राम राम, ग्रोच हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे। इसलिए प्रभुपाद कहते थे चिंता मत करो, खूब हरि नाम करो, कोई चिंता नहीं, खूब हरि नाम करो। अगर अभाव होगा ना, प्रभुपाद कहते थे मैं गोलोक वृंदावन से सोने की ईंट मंगा लूंगा। प्रभुपाद कहते हैं सोने की ईंट मैंने गोलोक वृंदावन से ला दूंगा, इसलिए कोई चिंता मत करो। है देखा ना कितने बड़ी बड़ी मठ बन रहा है, ये प्रभुपाद का आशीर्वाद है। साधारण एक व्यक्ति को घर में खाना मिलना, कितना सारा दिन परिश्रम करके भी खाना नहीं जुटा पाते, देखो कितने बड़े बड़े मठ है, कितने मठ मंदिर, कितने कहां से, राधा रानी की कृपा है और प्रभुपाद की कृपा है। इसलिए प्रभुपाद को चिंता मत करो। इसलिए प्रभुपाद कहते हैं मेरी जो गौड़ीय मठ और मेरे जो गृहस्थ का भक्त नहीं, गृहस्थ का जो घर नहीं, वो क्या है, बोले मैंने गोलोक वृंदावन से राधा रानी की निकुंज मंदिर को मैंने प्रकट कर दिया। वो कहते हैं राधा रानी गोलोक वृंदावन से निकुंज मंदिर को मैंने यहाँ प्रकट किया है। निकुंज मंदिर में क्या होता है, कहते ना मंगल श्री गुरु गौर मंगल मोरती मंगल श्री राधा कृष्णेर जुगल प्रीति। गोलोक वृंदावन में जो सखी मंजरिया हाँ ब्रह्म मुहूर्त राधा कृष्ण कैसे सो रहे हैं, आकर के आरती उतारते हैं, देखना गौड़ी मठ में वही हो रहा है। सवेरे उठ करके नहा धो करके तिलक लगा करके बस ठाकुर का आरती कीर्तन कर रहे हैं, गोलोक वृंदावन यहाँ भी चल रहा है। उसको बाद में सखी मंजरिया कृष्ण के लिए कैसे सुंदर सुंदर माला बनाती है, सुंदर सुंदर प्रसाद बनाती है, ठाकुर को खिलाती है, वहाँ होती है, यहाँ पर भी वही हो रही है। इसलिए प्रभुपाद बोलते थे मैं गोलोक वृंदावन के राधा रानी का निकुंज मंदिर को मैंने यहाँ पर उतार दिया। ये प्रैक्टिस यह प्रैक्टिस स्थल है, यहाँ पर ट्रेनिंग गौड़ीय मठ ने ट्रेनिंग, जो जितने बढ़िया ट्रेनिंग निकलेगा ना बस नौकरी वहां पर बढ़िया लग जाएगी, गोलोक वृंदावन उसकी नौकरी बढ़िया लग जाएगी। अगर यहाँ पर ट्रेनिंग अगर सही नहीं करोगे, हरिनाम नहीं करोगे, सेवा ठाकुर को पूजा मंगल आरती तुलसी परिक्रमा है, ये कहते इसकी सब ट्रेनिंग है, अगर ट्रेनिंग बढ़िया करोगे ना बस नौकरी बढ़िया मिलेगी, चकाचक राधा रानी के पास में बढ़िया नौकरी मिलेगी बस वहां पर, तो फिर तो चकाचक है वहां पर, जन्म मृत्यु दुख कष्ट खत्म, चिरकाल के लिए राधा जी की सेवा में लग जाएगी। इसलिए हम जो कुछ अभी थोड़ी बहुत तिलक लगा करके हरि नाम कीर्तन भजन के लिए कोशिश कर रहे हैं, इसलिए प्रभुपाद का ही कृपा है। ये प्रभुपाद नहीं आते, हम कभी भी कोई चाइना कोई रसिया कहीं कहां कहां से हम यहाँ एकत्रित होकर के हरि कीर्तन कथा कर रहे हैं, ये केवल प्रभुपाद का कृपा है। इसलिए हम प्रभुपाद से प्रार्थना करें, प्रभुपाद देखो अपना बेटे को प्रति जितना उनका, देखना एक व्यक्ति अपना बेटे में जितने उनकी आसक्ति जितने प्यार है ना, लेकिन बेटा का अगर बेटा हो जाए ना, पोता हो जाए, उससे ज्यादा आसक्ति। इसलिए हम लोग कौन है, प्रभुपाद की बेटे की बेटे हैं, और उसका अगर बेटे होना और ज्यादा आसक्ति है। इसलिए हम प्रभुपाद की बेटे के बेटे हैं। इसलिए तो वो क्या लगते हैं फिर हमारी ग्रैंडसन, ग्रेट ग्रैंड सन हम लोग हैं, ग्रेट ग्रैंड सन। इसलिए प्रभुपाद की हम बहुत नजदीक है, इसलिए उनकी बड़ी कृपा है आशीर्वाद। प्रभुपाद हम सबको पर आशीर्वाद करे, जैसे सारा जीवन देखो एक चीज लेकर के जाओ, प्रभुपाद का अंतिम उपदेश था, प्रभुपाद जब शरीर छोड़े इतना याद करो हरि बोल, इतना इतना चीज को लेकर के जाओ। प्रभुपाद कहते थे अंतिम उपदेश सत्य लांछना सत्य गंजना सत्य अपमान सुन करके भी हरि भजन नहीं छोड़ना, ये प्रभुपाद की अंतिम उपदेश है। हैं जीवन में भक्ति जब करोगे, कहते सत्यम सत्यन विघ्न नानी, सच बोल तो सब विघ्न है, विघ्न अजुतेन है, अगर कोई तपस्या करता हजार विघ्न, कहते विघ्न अजुतेन गोविंद, अगर कोई गोविंद का भजन करने के लिए जाए, कहते प्रति पद पद में विपत्ति है, प्रति पद पद में, बोले खुरस धारा भक्ति का धारा है, जैसे ब्लेड का धार है, बोले कोटि कंट करुध कटुर कांटा युक्त है। आप देखो गंदे रास्ता में जाओ कोई कुछ बोलेगा नहीं, शराब पियो सिगरेट फूको उल्टा पुल्टा कोई दुनिया कुछ बोलेगा नहीं, लेकिन थोड़ी तिलक लगा लो, गले में कंठी पहन लो, थोड़ी सी भजन कर लो, बोले ये क्या उम्र है, ये सब किया तिलक कंठी माला, देखना अब गंदे काम कर कोई दुनिया कुछ बोलेगा नहीं, लेकिन ये भक्ति करो ना, गांव के एक कुत्ता भी तुम्हारे पीछा नहीं छोड़ेगा, गांव के एक कुत्ता भी, इवन ए डग यू नो ही ऑल्सो फाइट विथ यू, सो कुत्ते भी यू नो कुत्ते भी आपको आपको पीछे लग जाएगा भजन। इसलिए प्रभुपाद का अंतिम उपदेश है, भगवान की भजन कभी नहीं छोड़ो, दुनिया छूट जाए एक दिन दुनिया छूटेगा ही, लेकिन भक्ति नहीं छूटनी चाहिए, क्योंकि अंतिम समय में बोलेंगे राम नाम सत्य है, गोपाल नाम सत्य है, सत्य बोल गत्य है सबका भजन, अंतिम समय बोलेंगे भैया जगत में सत्य है केवल भगवान की भक्ति, भगवान का नाम ही सच्चा है और जगत में सब झूठा है, फिर झूठा क्यों ले, फिर सच क्यों नहीं ले, ठीक है ना। इसलिए प्रभुपाद के अंतिम उपदेश, खूब भजन करो खूब भक्ति करो, ओके ठीक है। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे। प्रभुपाद की भक्ति, सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद की भक्ति, दैत माधव गोस्वामी महाराज की जय, भक्ति वल्लभ तीर्थ महाराज की, श्रीला भक्ति वेदांत श्री नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज की जय, सपरिकर गौर हरि की जय, प्रभुपाद की जय, हिताय गौर ब्रह्मानंदे महाप्रसाद की जय।